So this is Dave, and Dave is watching this, and apparently I get brought up for no reason. Is he, was this today? 9 hours ago. Lord of Dave, you should come on the stream, bro. You should come back. Come back to the stream. How do you feel about jelly? Sure, yeah, we'll do that in a second so you guys can hear the jelly rant that just happened, even though you missed it.
Others are speaking out. I'm keeping my gas stove.
Okay, this is not about me, for the record. I didn't even come up. Let's see. Let's see. Not a pry from my cold, dead hands. Hilarious. So I think the Republicans are, like, doing a bit, but they did this with the light bulb, so it's not really a bit. Like, they're lampshading it, but they all really, like, are also like, no, you can't take my gas stove. Like, if it's bad for you, and the FDA is like, we don't want people to sell gas stoves, it's bad for America and bad for these businesses, then I mean, they're just going to ban them. I mean, it's fine if you have this outside. Like, if you had like a little closed in thing outside, it's just when the gas is out. I mean, some people might still use them because, I mean, it's fire and it's good, but it's gas and it's bad for us. I don't know why you would choose to be mad about this. It's just weird. Like, I'm not going to come take your fucking stove. You can live with it. But, like, I don't think the FDA and everybody saying, like, hey, this is bad stuff. I really don't feel like that's debatable. Like, just it'll be more efficient in your life. I have an electric stove, but it's not because I didn't want gas. It's because I don't have a gas hookup there. Anyway, that's my take on the gas thing up front is who gives a fuck? No one's going to take your thing, but, like, it's bad for you. Live your life, bro. Leave your gas stove on. Poison your family. Just go for it. I love here, too, that, like, the virtue signal of turning on the gas stove and filming it for 5 seconds is so fucking cringe. And it's not even the most cringe thing Matt Gaetz is known for. It's the kids, Dave. It's the kids. So remember that when you go into this. Although you agree with him that kids are viable targets for your affection.
I have to pry it from my cold, dead hands.
Right. Oh, I'm sorry. Not kids. Not kids. That's my bad. Distinctly 18 to 21-year-old Nebraska farm girls. I have to correct myself. You're right. Specifically, Dave said, it's legal!
Pretty much me, too. You can't cook properly on an electric stove. You can't control the fucking heat.
That's just not true. I would 100% argue you can control the heat way better on electric stoves, particularly, was it an induction stovetop? But, no, he has a gas stove. I mean, gas is definitely good. I like gas. Like, imagine getting a tortilla, putting it over a gas stove. I have memories of this. But, like, you could do a coil heater or electric, and they both work fine. You can do induction. The temp control is like a key feature of it. You could see it in my cooking videos. You could see the temperature would be like 5, 7, stuff like that, and it'll let you regulate the temperature, and it'll kick on and off to sort of maintain that temperature. So he's just wrong. Surprise, Dave is wrong about a cooking thing. Shocker. He's gonna bring it up now.
Sorry, as somebody who cooks a lot
poorly,
you can't control the heat properly on an electric stove.
You can't control the heat properly on a gas stove, Dave. You can't. Specifically, you can't.
And yes, Jake, you can't. It is impossible to control the heat properly with an electric or an infrared stove.
An electric?
Tough fucking titty.
Why am I in his head? I'm not even... He rent-free. The only reason I'm looking at this, Dave, is because you mentioned me and someone showed me. I don't watch your show. That's funny, dude. Am I on this show? Does he do any of my stuff the rest of the time? So he's talking about gas stoves. He's not going to talk about anything I do? Coward. Pussy. Big Joel. God. Dave is such an embarrassment, bro. Like, actually an embarrassing person to interact with. Turn it up and down fast? I guess you just would cook it different. I don't know. It still gets hot. It still gets cool. You could just move it off the heat and change to another burner. You could just pull it off the heat for a second. Like, if you needed to cool down. I don't know. It's really not hard. Like, nothing. When you're, like, frying in a skillet or you're, I don't know. You don't really need, like, really accurate temperatures. It just needs to be. Maybe there's some stuff. But any of the stuff I can think of would require, like, a double boil, which regulates the temperature inherently. That's the point of the double boil. I mean, this needs to be warm enough or cool enough, depending on what you're doing. But that's sort of like a feel thing. I've never really... you could temp it with, like a blaster if you wanted to be sure. I guess I would only do that if I wasn't sure. But you just feel it with your hand, and you're like, yeah, that's hot enough. Maybe certain sauces are bad. I think... But it's not like a temperature thing. It'd just be like you can't bring it to a boil, or you have to bring it to a simmer and then bring it down. It'd be technique. It wouldn't be like a specific temperature for a sauce. It's always how the... I mean, maybe if you're... When it comes to like fucking confection, like if we're talking like sugar control, then definitely. But I don't think gas would necessarily be the play there. It's just making sure that you do it with the right timing and temperature control. I don't know. I can't imagine a situation where you need to be able to quickly lower the temperature in a way that you couldn't do by just moving it from the burner. But you could definitely bring them up. He seems to only cover your cooking reviews when they get posted to YouTube now, at least since the chat. Oh, woof. He hasn't reviewed our talk? Send this to Dave. Ready to clip this and send this to Dave? Hey, Dave, why don't you review the chat we had? That'd be too embarrassing. You could still use cast iron on induction, right? I actually don't know. I don't have an induction. Someone tell me what's up with the gas stove thing. I heard about it earlier, but I just know it's... Remember when the right wing got into the... It's the light bulb thing when George Bush or Obama light bulbs... They're like, hey, LED light bulbs are more efficient than shitty halogen ones. And then the Republicans were like, no, I'm buying my shitty light bulbs. And then, you know, everyone uses LEDs. And like, more efficient light bulbs now. And this is the same thing with gas stoves. Gas stoves have been found out to leak a lot of natural gas passively into the air around. And it fucks people's heads up. And so the FDA or whoever... put out a statement like, hey, this is what's happening. We may want to consider not selling gas stoves to consumers because it's bad for their health and it's a liability for the companies that sell them. The capitalists that are right-wingers that set up this system are now mad at the market reaction and the oversight committee on that market reaction for unsafe things in the market circulating around. It just doesn't make a lot of sense. They're just mad boys because someone that vaguely left, maybe liberal at best, said, hey, this is unhealthy for you. And they were like, nope, don't care. And it's like, I mean, I don't think anyone's going to come in and like force you to get your oven replaced. They're just not going to sell them, right? Or if they do, it'll be a way that's safe. And that's really it. They'll just make safer, better gas stoves, or they will make none of them. I don't know what getting worked up about means. And like, again, they're trying to say, like, they're trying to pretend they're not serious, but also they're mad. Like, there was really actually mad people about the gas stove thing. Pretty weird stuff.